Hello student, this is Purushottam Vishwakarma and I welcome you to this new video lecture related to Evans, Tries and O Level. Here, in this video, we shall discuss about page number 78. Before that, I would like to recapitulate whatever we have studied till now. This is the story of Evans, James Roderick Evans, who is nicknamed as Evans the Brick. Evans the Brick. Why? Because he has escaped the jail thrice. And this is the fourth time he is planning to escape. This is all about his plan, his execution of his plan, how he escaped, at the end how he was captured, and ultimately he had the last laugh. So there is a conflict between two characters, the governor of HM prison and Evans. So we shall discuss what we have already studied. First thing, Evans is in HM prison, who has decided to pursue German O level, German language. He started getting lessons in September. In the month of March, the governor of HM prison called the secretary of examination board. Both of them discussed together and they made arrangements, and the examination was scheduled to start on 8th June, Tuesday. All the arrangements were made. On 8th June, Evans had two visitors, Mr. Stevens and Mr. Jackson. Mr. Jackson was senior. Mr. Jackson told him to get ready for exam, to get safe, and they had warm enmity between them. He called him Einstein, laddie. Examination was scheduled to start at 9:15 a.m. But it was 9:12, the examination could not start. So ultimately, the examination started at 9:18 a.m. when the invigilator, Reverend Stuart McCleary, informed Evans regarding the center number, center code, regarding index number, and all those required things. And all these conversation is being listened by the governor. So let's see what happens next. We shall talk about page number 78. So here, silence 9:20 a.m. Evans had started his job. McCleary, I am now going to. McCleary started, I am now going to. Evans is not going to stay here, is he? He is not going to stay here. So Evans is feeling annoyance due to the presence of Stephens in the cell. Stephens was ordered to stay with them all the time, and Evans did not like it. So he said to the invigilator, he is going to stay all the time over my head, isn't he? He means to say, Stephens should not stay over there. He should leave the place. McCleary, I don't know about that. I don't know whether he is going to stay or not. I don't know about that. Stephens, Mr. Jackson has given me strict instructions too. Then Stephens said, Mr. Jackson, the senior prison officer, his senior, had given him instructions to stay there in the cell itself. And all these things were being listened to by HM prison's governor. He wants, how am I supposed to concentrate on my exam? If you are going to stay over my head, over my shoulder, how am I going to concentrate on my exam? With someone breathing down my neck, standing just beside me. Christ, sorry sir, I did not mean. He knew very well that someone was listening to him. That is why he said, Christ, I should not have said like that. He trying to apologize. Governor reached for the phone. After listening this conversation, after hearing this, Governor reached for the phone. He called Jackson. Ah, good. Get Stephens out of that cell. Get Stephens out of that cell. Well, he was there in the cell. So get Stephens out. I think we are perhaps doing thing. Perhaps we are doing things. Overdoing things. We are overdoing. We are being over smart. That is not fair. As you wish, sir. Then Stephens was called outside by Jackson. Jackson said, as you wish, sir. Whatever you say, sir, I do the same. The governor heard the exchange in the cell. So exchange sound was heard. While he was coming out, the governor heard the exchange sound. Stephens was taken out. The door clanged once more. Once again the door closed and there was clang sound. And heard McCleary announce that the examination had begun at last. And governor heard McCleary announcing that the examination had started. It was 9:25 a.m. Now the time was 9:25 a.m. and there was a great calm. Great calm. Nobody was speaking anything. At 9:40 a.m. when it was about to over, the examination was of 2 hours. 9:40 a.m. the examination board rang through. At 9:40, after 15 minutes, there was a call from examination board. And the assistant secretary with special responsibility for modern languages asked to speak to the governor. So there was a person who called himself the assistant secretary of the examination board. He called the governor and said he had to talk to the governor. The examination had already started. It had been 15 minutes. No doubt, a quarter of an hour ago, that means 15 minutes ago. Yes, well, there was a correction slip which some fool had forgotten to place in the examination package. That assistant secretary reported that there was a slip missing, that correction is required in the question paper. Some fool had missed it. Forgotten to place in the examination package. Very brief, could the governor please? Very brief it is, very small correction slip is it is. Could the governor please? He wanted to correct it. Yes, of course, I'll put you straight through to Mr. Jackson in D wing. Hold the line a minute. So governor said, don't worry, I'll directly connect you to D wing, to the cell, to Mr. Jackson. Was this the sort of thing the governor had feared? The governor thought. Was this the sort of thing that the governor had feared? Is this a plan, a trap? Was the phone call a fake? He thought all these things. Whether the phone call is a fake call, some signal, some message, some secret message. But he could check on that immediately. But he had enough time. He could check on that immediately. How? He will call. He dialed the number of the examination board. When he dialed the number of the examination board, he heard the busy sound, busy dial tone. Only the staccato beeps of a line engaged. Staccato, when the line is engaged, there is a different kind of sound. Not regular dial tone is heard. You may have heard the dial tone of a receiver. When the line is engaged, there is a long beep staccato. But then a line was engaged, wasn't it? How can you call? The person is calling you from that place only, and the line is already engaged, so there will be no call at all. Yes, not very intelligent that. It was not a very intelligent idea. 2 minutes later, he heard some whispered communications. After 2 minutes, he heard some whispered communications. He heard whispering sounds in the cell, and then McCleary brought Scott's voice. Then he heard Mr. McCleary, Stuart McCleary's broad Scottish voice. He spoke in a Scottish accent. "Will you please stop writing a wee while for a while, Mr. Evans, and listen carefully?" So what he said, he had some message, and he ordered Mr. Evans, his examinee, to stop for a while because he was going to convey a message through a slip that he got. What was the message? "Candidates offering German 021-1. What was the message? "Candidate offering German 021-1 should note the following correction." You should note the following correction. What is the correction? What is the message? On page 3, line 15, page 3, line 15, the fourth word should read goldenen, goldenen, not goldeny. And the whole phrase will therefore read zum goldenen loven. It would be read like this: zum goldenen loven, not zum goldenen loven. So he means to say, you must mind this line. It was a message for Evans. Golden Lion was a hotel. And he means to say, after running from here, after escaping from here, you have to go to this place, Golden Lion, the hotel Golden Lion. "I'll repeat that," he said. "I'll repeat it." Then he repeated once again, "But I'm not going to repeat anymore. That's all for the day. Have a nice day."